I'm bad like the Barbie. I'm a dog, but I still wanna party. Being bad like I'm ready to bend. I'm a 10, so I pull in a...
Get in, loser. We're going shopping.
Welcome back to my channel. If you are new, then welcome to my channel. It is Day back again with another video for y'all. So if you haven't read that title already, we're going to be doing some makeup today. We're going to be doing a makeup look. I don't know exactly what type of look. I just know it's going to be pink. But yeah, I pulled out literally everything so that we can just, you know, experiment and get into it. I really want to try to do like a cut crease. I've never done a cut crease before, but I'm here for the vibes. I'm not doing anything. It's literally midnight right now and I'm just, you know, vibing with life right now. So yeah, let's go ahead and hop into this video, but I want to start with drinks. I just feel like I want to get the vibes going. So of course, I have some ice cold water, of course, because I'm going to be sitting here for a minute trying to do this makeup. So yeah, we got to stay hydrated with the water since we're going to be sitting here for a while. But I also have some wine. And this one is Pinot Grigio. My bestie always talks about Pinot Grigio. I've never tried it, so we're about to try it together. So let me go ahead and pour that. It's not bad. It's pretty good, actually. It's kind of in between, like, bitter and sweet. It's, like right in the middle, I feel like. Because it's really sweet, but it has, like, a little bitter aftertaste, in my opinion. And I actually like the fact that it's not too sweet because I'm trying to be on a diet. So I'm trying to cut out sugars and dairies and stuff like that. So I don't feel as guilty about having this glass of wine because I really shouldn't be having it at all. But it's not that sweet as I thought it was going to be. I'm honestly about to put my hair in a claw clip so that it's not like in the way. Yeah. Okay, so now that all of that is out the way, let's get into like what you're actually here for, which is the makeup. So let's go ahead and just hop into the video. First things first is primer. So we're going to be using the e.l.f. Power Grip Primer. Yeah, the one with the niacinamide in it that's been like viral and everywhere. It's this one and that green one. It's like a greenish blue type of color, whatever. But yeah, them two right there. Yeah, so this is my first time ever trying it. So let's go ahead and do it. And I'm kind of just trying to glide it on. They said not to like massage it into your skin. It's just supposed to like sit on top of the skin. So I'm trying not to like put it in too much. This one is like really sticky in my opinion. I don't really know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. I'm no like makeup expert, but we're gonna find out. Okay, so now that we're all primed, I think I'm gonna start with my eyebrows, to be honest, and go downward since I'm doing a eye look that I've never tried before. So let's just go ahead and hit the brows. So first thing what I'm gonna do is use the NYX Brow Gel. I love it, swear by it. And this is why I love the NYX Brow Gel. Like, the product just speaks for itself. Like, look at this eyebrow versus this eyebrow. And yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and do the other eyebrow. I love this stuff. Like, whoever came up with this, oh my gosh, they need the biggest raise. They need the best of life, all the luxuries. I was gonna say something wild, but we just gonna keep this, you know, PG. We gonna keep it PG. But you snapped, whoever made this. Okay, so now that my brows look like this, I'm going to take another sip because I feel like I deserve it. And then we're going to fill them in just a tad bit more. Ooh, now we're getting tipsy at midnight. My eyebrows look great, but I'm gonna fill them in just a tad bit more with some brow pomade in an angle brush. I just like this because I just feel like a little bit goes a long way. And for my brows, they just aren't as full as I would like them in some areas. So I usually like make a line under because I'm like lacking hair right there. So I kind of just make a line under, not harsh. And then I kind of just do like a feather motion. I'm no expert at this, but literally just try to be light and do like feather-like strokes. And it makes it just a little more realistic. And it's not so heavy than you like dragging the product on there like we used to do, you know, back in the day. So I'm new to this too because I definitely used to fill my eyebrows all the way in, babes. And some days I still do it, so. But I like this little hack for it to look a little bit more natural. And then, like I said, just take, you know, some feather-like strokes to just fill in spots you feel that are needed. But you don't want to fill it in too much to where it looks too, you know, drawn in or whatever. But yeah, you can see like how big of a difference it is, but it's a very like subtle, small difference. All right, so now that this eyebrow is done, I'm gonna do the other one and I'll be back. Wait a minute. Okay, so I went ahead and used a little bit of concealer to go under the eyebrow just to make it, you know, a little bit more clean, a little bit sharper. You know, you see the difference. You'll see it. Yeah, so that's what I'm doing right now. And then after the eyebrows, I'm honestly just going to move down to the lid. I don't know what I'm doing, so I'm honestly just going to do it. And y'all are going to watch me do it. We're just going to do it together, you know? And I'm gonna take another sip. This wine is starting to go to my head, but like in the best way. I feel lovely. I was trying to find a brush to like even this out. I feel like brushes are a little better than beauty blenders, but I still use both. So I'm gonna use a beauty blender and damp it a lot. Like a lot. And then I'm going to blend out. So we just gonna blend it out so that I can move downward. Okay, so now I feel like we can get to the fun part, which is putting on the eyeshadow. I'm so nervous because I don't want to mess it up and I don't want to have to like wipe it off, because when I get frustrated and it don't look good, I'm gonna trust the process for like a hot second, but I'm quick to wipe it off. Like, I'll start over. But yeah, so I'm gonna be using this palette because I just don't feel like any other palette really does this pink justice. It's between using this or taking a play from this girl who did my makeup. She used this Juvia's Place. Why I literally bought it because she did my makeup with it and I was in love, so I bought it. But yeah, she used this palette to do eyeshadow and blush and stuff, and it was really cute. So I'm thinking, maybe should I do that, like play with this palette too? I don't know, like let's try it. Like, why not. I'm not gonna create the same exact look, Avi, but I just feel like she, yeah, she did her thing. It's just so cute and Barbie-like, right? Yeah, so we're gonna play with this. I don't know much about cut crease, but I feel like I need transition, like something like depth or something, and I don't know if they start with the lightest color or the darkest color. Oh my gosh. I could like kick myself, but I'm not gonna Google it. I'm just gonna like go with the flow. But I really do think that I need like a darker color in the crease. I don't know. I just wanna start. Let's see. guys, so this is what we're working with so far. So pretty and like pigmented. But yeah, I'm gonna do the other side and we're gonna figure out what to do next. Yeah, definitely feeling myself. So this is what it's looking like with both done. And what I'm doing right now is just taking some concealer, the same concealer that I use for my under eyebrow, whatever. I'm putting some on my hand just because I don't know what's what, y'all. So I want to be able to like have a little bit of control. So yeah, I'm doing that. And then I'm going to dip this brush. I thought this was a decent one to do. Maybe I should do one that's smaller. Maybe I should do one that's smaller, but I really don't know. I'm going to go with this one. I just feel like this one's going to be okay. I don't know. So we're going to go with this, and we're just going to really take our time and, like, really just try to do this, like... Was I supposed to wipe it first? I thought I brought makeup wipes out here because I thought that was definitely a step to like wipe it, but I just feel like I'm in too deep. Like, I don't know, like, is this right? Like, is this going well? Like, I don't know, I feel like it needs to be like more. So let me work on it and then I'll come back. I don't know, y'all. Okay, so now I'm getting irritated because I'm done now and it's cute, but my eye wanna start watering like already, please. Like, it's watering and I need it to stop because I don't want it to ruin the makeup look. Like, please don't piss me off. I'm vibing right now, living my best life. So we're gonna go back in with this and do the light color on the inner and kind of go back in with the dark. I don't know. And I got some glitter too. Like, we just about to make it do what it do. So now we got this pretty pink color. Back in with the outer and kind of, I don't know if I need to do like bring it in some, like, I really don't know. Like, I don't know if I need to that. I'm about to put this glitter on here and see how I feel. But first I'm gonna take another sip. I feel like I ain't been sipping. I'm hoping this don't spill everywhere because I don't have time to be cleaning up glitter. Like, I don't even know if it's sticking. I don't know what's what right now. I feel like all the glitter literally went on my face. So fun. And then I'm gonna try these to try to like really define that line. And we're gonna see if it's cute. And then I'm gonna do whatever I do to this side, to the other side. I wanna figure out how to make the glitter stick better. I probably should have used like a glue or something, but I don't want it to be like cakey. And I feel like now it's getting like weird and cakey. I don't know what I'm doing. I need help. But yeah, I'm thinking I might use this one. I feel like this is a good one to define that line. So this pack right here, these gel eyeliners I got from Amazon, is definitely in my Amazon storefront, or the link is down below if you guys need some too. Colored, like literally all colors of the rainbow liners. And I just feel like I probably need a closer mirror. So I'm gonna use my Fenty mirror, y'all. Hold on. Cause this is getting serious right now. I need this line to be like very sharp. I don't know, besties. Like, am I doing something? Am I doing something? Like, I don't know. Okay, so this is what I created so far, and this is the vibes. I have the urge to put some rhinestones on this look too, and I just feel like I should bring in this dark color in like right here too. So let me just go ahead and do that. And then I'm gonna start adding some rhinestones, the pink ones. Probably these right here, between these and these, or probably like a combination. I don't know. I'm just going with the flow. So let me see what I do, and then I'll tell y'all what I do. Okay, so this is the vibe that I created, and now I'm just going to hit the bottom lash line with a little bit of black eyeliner to really just pull it together before I put the lashes on. I think I'm gonna put the lashes on at the end. I just like to put them on at the end. I just feel like, I don't know, the less time that I have them on my face, the better for me. But yeah, this is the vibes. I think it's really, really cute. Very Barbie-esque. But yeah, I'm gonna hit the bottom lash line. What I did was fill in, like I said, put some more of the dark. I filled that in. I added the gems. I did 5, and I kind of alternated the colors between light and dark. And then I hit the bottom lash with light, and then I ombre'd it to dark to kind of just blend in with this. And that's what I did. And I think it's cute. I like it. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. Yeah, I'm not gonna drag it like all the way and do the whole one. I just kind of want to meet up where the under eyeshadow kind of is, and kind of just ombre it out. Okay, so these are the eyes, both finished, and now I'm trying to decide on what lashes I want. I wanted to use these lashes that I got from Amazon. So yeah, it was a 4-pack, but I used another pair that was in the pack, and I really, really like these. I've definitely went down a few sizes for my lashes. I really just like 18 millimeter lashes or whatever. Y'all remember I used to love like 25, the ones that like you fly away. I've calmed down a lot. So I love these. They're very affordable on Amazon, link down below. But yeah, they're super affordable, and I just like getting them in the pack because, like, I don't know, I'll wear strips like 2 times, and then like when the glue get too gunky, like I'm not really with the cleaning off. Like I really will just throw them away or pick a new pair of lashes. But anyway, yeah, I'm debating between these. The one that I'm leaning towards is these, I think. I'm leaning towards these the most, but the other two look like this. And this one. So yeah, I think I'm gonna go with this one, but yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and do the rest of my face before I do my lashes. I just don't really want that on my face right now. So yeah, let's go ahead and do the face. And if you thought I wasn't taking sips in between, you thought wrong. I'm definitely taking sips. Alright, so these are the 3 items I'm gonna be using. I've honestly been loving this NYX Blur foundation. Like, I've been using this as my everyday, like, makeup routine type of vibe or whatever. Like, when I say blur, like, they did not lie, blur into my skin. Like, I love this. So let's go ahead and use it. Yeah, I couldn't wait. Like, as you can see, I've been using it. I was trying to wait, do it on camera, first impressions. This product, I couldn't wait. I could not wait. So yeah, let's just go ahead and put that all over. And like, tell me that doesn't give blur. And I didn't even use like my good blending brush where I can like press it into the skin. Like, oh, they just ate with that. Most definitely. And I do look very pale, very ghastly, but just like, give me a second. We're still looking very pale, but I haven't did my contour, so until I do my contour I'm gonna keep looking pale anyway. I'm trying to do my under eye without like messing up the eyeshadow, but I'm gonna hit the inners with a little of the Tarte Shape Tape. Yeah, really just the inners real quick, and you have to wear quick with Shape Tape. I learned that very fast. Yeah, because it will dry. I'm also gonna take the Huda Beauty color corrector, I think this is, but I've been using it as like blush or to do like the ombre thing or whatever, and that's what I'm about to do. I don't know if peach is like the best color, but I don't know, I'm just feeling like this is what I'm gonna do. So yeah, those are pretty thick, so I just thickened those up. But yeah, bada boom, bada bing, I'm gonna blend this out. Be right back. So I use these powder puffs that I get from Amazon. They literally come in like a pack of like 6 or 8. I have some more here in my little case. But yeah, I love these powder puffs. They're so good for blending purposes. And I'm just going to blend out that Shape Tape in the necessary spots, but I'm not gonna touch this yet until I do the other side, because I don't want the colors to like blend and bleed and then it's just messed up and it's not seamless on both sides or whatever. So yeah, so that's this side. Let me do the other side and blend it out. Okay, so usually I use my Fenty Beauty Coco Naughty 2 contour. This is like my go-to. But I purchased this NYX Wonder Stick for contouring, and I want to use this today. I'm not necessarily worried about the lighter part, because I kind of already did that already. So yeah, I'm going to use the darker part, because I already did the lighter part, and I put powder. I use Airspun powder to already like set the light parts. So now I'm about to work on my contour to give some more warmth and depth into the face. But yeah, I've been seeing good things about this NYX Wonder Stick, and I want to see for myself like what's what. This is in the shade medium tan, I guess. It's for medium tones. I think they had like a light, a dark, and a medium. I forgot. But to my knowledge, I think that's what it is. And I got the medium one, so I'm just trying to find like my cheekbones and kind of go up and do that. And kind of just trying to go where I would put my Coco Naughty. The consistency is really good for this. It's really smooth. And you don't have to press hard at all to get like the product to come out or whatever. And then I like a little bit of contour up here, blend that out, and then find my cheekbones. Something like that. And then I'm gonna have to blend it out. So give me a second. Okay, so this is me attempting to blend it out. I would say first impressions, I like it. But Coco Naughty for the win, Coco Naughty. But yeah, to say first impressions, I like it. I just have to like blend it out and get it to be where it's not so harsh and like noticeable but not noticeable. And then I tried the other side, which I said I wasn't gonna use, but it was more like a highlighted stick, so I used it on my nose and like literally like right here, so that when I blend, hopefully everything will come together. So I'm using this double-sided e.l.f. brush. This baby, yeah, get you a double-sided Elf Fresh. I have multiple of these, and they are just game changers. So I'm just trying to like buff it out as much as I can so that it doesn't look so harsh. Even though it probably still will, but I'm trying. Okay, baby, so this is where we're at now. We're pretty much done with the face. Now I'm adding blush, and so I'm going back in with the Juvia's Place, and I'm using the darker hot pink shade, and I'm just putting that on the cheek. As you can see, it's so pigmented. I was trying to be light, but it's very pigmented. And I'm just dragging that up on the face. And then I put a little bit on the bridge of my nose because that's what I like to do. Lots of blush, blush galore. It's not an everyday look, clearly. But we're having fun. Very Barbie-esque. Alright, and so I'm taking a beauty blender and just kind of toning it down a little bit. I don't know, I'm just kind of like going over it just to like get it to chill out a little bit. Okay, so now I'm gonna put glue on the lash and then focus on the lips, and that's pretty much the look. I could go ahead and spray, so I guess I'm gonna go ahead and do that. I'm gonna use my Charlotte Tilbury, and we're almost down to the bottom, but we're gonna use the Charlotte Tilbury. Okay, while I have glue on the lashes, we're gonna tackle the lips. I need y'all to, you know, bear with me because this is the first two. But I saw this girl do this on TikTok, I think, with this liquid blush in the shade Blush Lily. This liquid blush. And I'm going to take my brown lip liner and we're going to do a lip combo for the first time. I don't know if this brown is like too dark, but... Okay, babies, the lips are very much lined, so moving on. Something like that. I know this is looking very scary. I kind of want to go back in with brown and then like smooth it out with another brush or something. But this is how it's looking so far. Okay, so lashes are on, however they are too long. I was just too lazy to get up and get the scissors, but yeah, I'm only wearing it for a hot second. But this is the lashes. I'm about to go back into the lips. I kind of want to see about doing, I don't know, I'm just experimenting today, so I kind of want to like try. So the last thing that I did was just put some clear gloss on, literally, to make it shiny. And I'm trying to figure out, do I like it? I feel like it's different for sure. But, I don't know how I feel about this, like, lip liner situation. I might go back in and try to, like, blend it a little bit so it's not, like, so harsh. I just feel like it's a little bit too harsh for the coloring. Like, I don't know. So I'm gonna do that, and then after that, I'm pretty much done, babes. Like, this is pretty much, you know, the look, the vibes. I'm gonna give you guys like a different angle and a close-up and all of that, but this is pretty much, you know, what it's giving. And I feel cute. I feel like a Barbie, for sure, for sure.
And I'm bad like the Barbie. I'm a dog, but I still wanna party. Pink felt like I'm ready to bend. I'm a 10, so I pull in a 10. Like Gabby, Stacey, Pinky, Pop. All of the Barbies is pretty damn. All of the bodies is bad. It's girls, and we can play tag. Red, but he spank me when I get bad. I'm in LA, Rodeo Drive. I'm in New York, Madison Ave. I'm a Barbie girl. Pink Barbie dream house. The way Kim be killing shit got me yelling out like the scream house. If you're yelling out, we ain't selling out. We got money, but we ain't lending out. We got bars, but we ain't billing out. In that pink Ferrari, we peeling out. I told Tay, bring the vibe, peeling out.